Lake Resources Limited on the ASX LKE is undertaking an aggressive exploration program in Argentina. Now, as well as lithium projects in brine, Lake also has lithium projects in pegmatites. And here to talk about that today is Steve Promnitz, the MD of Lake Resources. Hello, Steve.
Great to see you again, Tim. Thank you very much.
Now, you've just got a really exciting announcement out about the Jujuy project, the Jujuy province, and something that's been years in coming. But before we talk about that, let's just get a refresher on what Lake's strategy is.
Right. Essentially, we set up this company privately 2 years ago with a focus on Argentina. Argentina had just changed government. The area in northern Argentina and northern Chile is where half the world's lithium comes from. So we thought that's a great place to go, and let's go in there when the government's just changing, because it had been a no-go destination. Then we put those properties into this listed vehicle, Lake Resources. They had the right name, they'd been in Argentina before, and that's worked out pretty well. Three brine projects, as you mentioned, in Jujuy, two in Jujuy province, one in Catamarca province, plus a hard rock. And we're fortunately one of the largest landholders of leases in Argentina for lithium. So it's the right place to be, we're in the right address, we've got scale, right sort of property size, and a variety of different projects, and each one of those can be a company maker.
Now, lithium is, of course, one of these new strategic minerals because they're using it in electric cars, batteries, and who knows what's going to happen in the future.
Indeed.
But what's really significant about this that people may not realise is that your projects, your large tenement holding, which as you mentioned is the largest, is actually in the area where half of the world's lithium is produced.
No, that's exactly why we went there. And it's interesting, we couldn't quite duplicate what everybody else was doing. So on our catchy project in Catamarca, we picked up a basin that had been a little forgotten, pegged the whole thing, and we're drilling that at the moment. And then the other areas in Jujuy province that we're talking about, that's actually right next to current production. And some of the players in the industry have said, well, why aren't you in the middle of the salt lake? And we've said, well, actually, we've done our targeting. We've looked at how these basins are formed. We're actually targeting covered areas, alluvial cover on the edge of these basins. There's faults that go down into these brine aquifers, and that's actually our target. And that's what's so exciting about today's announcement. We can actually get out there and start doing this work.
Steve, this isn't the only project that you've got going on. You've got another one as well with some drilling activity. Tell us about that.
Yeah, it's called the Catchy Project. It's in Catamarca province. What's nice about that, we've pretty much got the whole basin tied up. And so we started drilling there in November. Drilling started okay, but unfortunately we ran into some problems. Perversely, the problems we run into is exactly what you'd want. We've found this great sandy horizon. You know, think oil and gas, it's the same in brines. You want a nice permeable horizon. We've got some good conductivities out of it, so that's a good indication, but we haven't been able to get samples out of it. So we've brought in a different rig, a rotary rig. We're actually bringing another one in the next couple of days. So we'll have two rigs there to try and get some results out, because we need some results so we can actually show where this thing can go and give some idea of scale.
Let's talk about today's Jujuy announcement.
All right, well, it really is a landmark. There's only a few large players there. So SQM ponied up with Lithium Americas nearly 2 years ago. 2 years ago this month, Orocobre has been in production there now for 2 years, and Advantage Lithium have ponied up with Orocobre recently. So there's a pretty small coterie of people there. We were fortunate that we'd pegged this ground 2 years ago when really it wasn't of interest, and a lot of the players there had already had the central part of the basin, you know, I don't need everything, and we were able to specifically target these areas, pick them up. Unfortunately, the province had a few issues they had to deal with. There's been some delays. We've essentially been frozen out for the last 2 years. And so with this agreement, it's actually signed off together with the province to then show that these leases are moving forward. So we're now going to be inside the tent with a pretty small group. And that's pretty exciting. Exciting for now, exciting for the future.
Absolutely. In terms of taking it through to production, which is the ultimate goal here, is it possible that you'd be able to utilise infrastructure that's already in place with the other producers that are there?
Well, there's a number of different things. First of all, there's infrastructure all around. You've got roads, you've got power lines, gas lines, what have you. And one of those roads is an international that goes straight across the border to Chile, to the ports at Iquique and Antofagasta. So one option is you can actually export concentrated brine. Second is Orocobre has a plant, SQM Lithium Americas are looking at building a plant, so there's going to be plants in the areas that you could also utilise. And alternatively, there's some new technologies being developed at the moment, direct extraction using either membranes or different forms of ion exchange, where potentially you could build a smaller plant where you extract that directly. So there's a number of different options. Each of those are probably somewhere in the 2 to 3.5 years. They're not immediate, but the good thing is there's a coterie of people who want to be in this patch, who want to pony up with somebody like ourselves to actually put these things into action.
Mm. Well, with such a large tenement package and being early movers on this ground, I think there's considerable opportunity for Lake Resources. And if you're watching, and of course you are right now, Lake Resources is listed on the Australian Stock Exchange with the ticker code LKE and lakeresources.com.au. And thank you very much, Steve, for coming in and talking to us.
Excellent. Appreciate it. I look forward to the next time.